After researching, it was time to get sketching. I wanted to make sure my designs and ideas reflected Willa Smith's star image, but also her genre. Once I had an idea of how I wanted the Digipak to look, I set about finding the right picture of my actress Annie. I wanted something that would symbolise Willow Smith's star image, but also be original. After some searching, I found the perfect picture. My Digipak research enabled me to get a clearer idea of how a soul slash neo soul Digipak should look. Taking on inspiration from Willow Smith, Erykah Badu and Saint Heroine, I decided I would incorporate a heavy amount of artwork, taking on the theme of 1920s jewels and royalty found in Saint Heroine's Digipak. I proceeded to sketch out in the least artistic and amazing fashion the front cover of my Digipak. First sketching out my actress Annie, then adding a jeweled halo, flowers, gems, diamonds and other vivid and extravagant imagery. I then proceeded to sketch the back of my Digipak. For the back, I decided to sketch a gold border, keeping in with the theme of the front cover. I then decided to add the name of the album again and the artist's name, Willow Smith, and also add the track list. All of these features are incredibly conventional, as I've found in my research. I also added a barcode, the label that Willow Smith is signed to, and her website so that fans can get extra information. On the inside of the Digipak, I included the plastic tray for the disc to sit on. The background of the plastic tray is bordered the same way as the back cover to keep everything consistent. On the inside of the Digipak, it is conventional to find another image of the artist. However, Willow Smith isn't an orthodox artist who follows the conventional norms. Therefore, I've decided to mimic the original EP cover and have no image. Instead, I've presented three white blocks as seen on the original EP.